Boat project. Pronounce. An apparently simple task that you carefully plan in order to achieve an improvement of your boat. A boat project will systematically take at least twice the time you had forecasted, requires countless trips to the hardware store to get the tools and supplies you don't have, involves you tearing apart your boat and building it back up, reveals at least 5 other boat projects that need to be taken care of in the meantime, while putting your relationship in jeopardy. So, last week, we installed solar panels. Okay, I exaggerate a little bit. It wasn't actually that bad, it's just that it was our first major sailboat refit. Major. And it turned out a lot more challenging than we thought it would. I'm sure that some of you have gone through way worse sailboat projects. And if you have, please share your experience in the comments. We love to hear about other people's stories. Now, before I go in, what solar panels we install and how we install them and how it went, I want to rewind a little bit for the non-sailors out there and explain why it's so important for us to have solar panels on board. When you do the kind of sailing that Ryan and I want to do, which is being out at sea for longer periods of time, we have systems on board that require energy. Systems like the GPS, the radar, the VHF radio, or my favorite, the fridge, that are up and running constantly. To cater those energy needs, we have batteries on board. And those batteries need to be recharged now and then. On the sailboat, you have a few options. You could, for example, run the engine, and running the engine will recharge the batteries. But we feel that it's not a sustainable option for us because first it consumes diesel and we don't like to run the engine so much. We used to have a wind generator, but the wind generator made a lot of noise and it was installed right above the cabin in which we sleep, and it didn't produce enough energy for us to feel that it was worth it. And without further ado, this is how the solar panel project went.
So today is April 7th and we are about to start a big solar panel project. So I've purchased, about almost 400 watts of flexible solar panels that you can walk on. So these are from Sunbeam Systems, which is a Swedish company. It was right before we pulled the trigger on buying these, because they're not exactly cheap, they came out with a new model that had, with their 30 watt panels, had about 20% more power in them. So instead of 30 watts, there were 38 watts for the same surface area. So it's really great. But this is a fun project for me.
This is a fun project for me.
And so that's why we picked Sunbeam, and maybe I'll write more about that on our website later. So I have 3 different sizes of panels that we're going to use. I have 5 38 watt panels, 2 56 watt panels, and an 80 watt panel. And if I did my calculations correctly, we should have 5 of these up here, and that's going to give us close to 400 watts. I think it's about 380 watts. And the way that these panels are designed, you can really use them all on the same MPPT, the charge controllers. So yeah, that's the project for today, but the biggest issue is going to be figuring out where to drill the holes to get the wires in. Okay, now I'm going to go work. And they seem to fit just how I had planned. I have them covered up right now because I don't want them producing any power. So now I'm trying to figure out where I'm going to put the deck gland to run the wires in. It's the first time I drilled a hole in our boat. So I'm going to take this off. I'm going to get no water. Yeah, it just needs to lay flat, okay?
Ow.
You alright?
Sailing is not about fun.
It's a bit challenging, this project, as you can see by the looks of the boat.
It's like a bomb went off.
Yeah.
Huh. Okay. We had to run this metal wire.
You had to run this metal wire.
To find the path, because you can't get to any of this stuff because of how the boat is constructed. So we started going this way, but we kept getting stuck on an angle. So we decided to take it the other way and bring it up through here originally. And when we did that, it went past, like, back to here and got stuck on something, and we can't move it. It's like... So...
What are you gonna do with this?
Well, it's just gonna live up there now. So we're gonna cut it. I need to get a tool to do that, because I have nothing.
Yeah, but this all... Just ignore.
It doesn't look very good.
So it's probably another couple days of work, but we're getting pretty close, I think. The boat's ripped apart. It's pretty awesome.
So. Yeah, the boat looks... Yeah.
Day 557 on this desolate planet. Oh, wrong video. Day 3! Solar panel time! Sophie wants me to film. I don't know how to film. I got this light shadow thing going on. Day 3, solar panels. I have to show you this. I bought 5 meter spools cable. 5 are roughly the same length. 3 are like fucking a meter short. That's shit. I'm gonna complain.
Meatballs is the national food of Sweden. Microwave meatballs is the national food of Ryan. Well, other than pizza.
Hey guys, today I'm at the marina and it's the 5th day that we are working on the solar panels. I actually left the office in the middle of my workday to go help Ryan because he had a bit of a mental breakdown.
This is not going very well.
So what essentially happened is that placing the solar panels on the deck, that was no problem, but it was dragging the cables from the deck down to the batteries that was getting a bit of an issue.
I got another one of these wires stuck in. So it's probably gonna, every time we rock the boat, we're gonna hear this ding, ding. So I gotta figure out how to fix that later. The old plan was to take wires through here on the other side of this wall down and then run them back to the batteries. It's not working at all.
Okay.
New plan maybe is to take wires through the headliner to the back here, and then the sticking point, which I don't know about yet because the screw is stripped, is if I can drill through this wall that has a bunch of glue on it into the other side and then run the cables down the batteries.
We're getting there.
There's been like a screw that's held the headliner up that we couldn't get out. Finally, I just used the Dremel tool and we cut the top of it off and pulled the thing down. It looks like the first screw that was in there got stuck, and then they cut the head off it and put another screw in right next to it. And then there's like some nails there or some staples. It's just crazy. Getting there. This is the last wire I need to connect to other wires, and then I just need to connect everything down there.
It's starting to look good.
Yeah. So our solar panel wires, I know it looks a bit overkill, but this is how I wanted to do it. It's all about being able to access the wires if something's wrong,
and being able to get to fuses that you have. This was really the best way I could think of to do it, given how this boat is set up. So it is a lot of wire. There's probably a way to do it with a lot less wire, but it would cause access problems if a fuse blew or if I needed to get to one wire to fix something. So this is how it's done.
You like how nice and neat and organized this looks?
What organization exactly are you talking about?
The last 2 weeks we have scraped the entire bottom of the hull, painted epoxy, put new anti-fouling on, and put 40 watts of solar panels on, and tried to maintain jobs. I think it's pretty good.
That was pretty good. High five. Okay, today is Friday, the 13th.
Oh,
And we've been working for what?
A week.
A week on installing the solar panels, and finally they're on the deck.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull the covers off.
Okay, verdict.
I think it's working just fine, according to what says on there.
Is it?
Yeah.
So you've installed solar panels?
Mm-hmm.
Officially?
Well, let's see what the battery monitor says. Battery monitor.
That doesn't help.
No. Uh-huh, that's why that's not working. Because there is no power to it. Yeah, it seems to be working.
That's awesome!
So, after this exciting solar project, I have calmed down with anxiety and frustration enough to talk. There was a little bit of swearing and yelling, and the boat got sold a few times. It got unsold, sold again. Pretty much sums it up. But our harbor master here and helpful friend Magnus, who is a boat mechanic, gave me a lot of encouragement and told me some of his own stories about how he just wants to cry sometimes when he's working on boats, and that's exactly how I felt. So that made me feel not alone. Without my love for the ocean,
I would be long gone by now. Hi guys, thank you so much for watching this. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, and you want to get a notification each time we publish a new video, consider subscribing. And Ryan and I will catch you next time on a new episode of Ryan and Sophie are undertaking a huge boat project that is taking way longer than it should. Bye bye!
Then $5 to happy dude. Let's
go. All right.
Oh yeah, I got another cable stuck today too.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Where?
Behind all here, but I think I can get it out.
Oh my god.
I think I can get it out.